In this video, I show you how to create YouTube Shorts in Shotcut.
Hi everyone, my name is Joe and welcome to Ubitronics. On this channel, I show you how to use open source software. Today, we're looking at YouTube Shorts and how to create Shorts in Shotcut. So the first thing we want to do is open Shotcut and give it a name. I'm going to just call it Test Short. In the video mode, this is the important part here. We click onto video mode and you may have any one of these selected or a custom one. What we need to do is go to custom and add a new custom field. Give it a name. I'm going to call mine YouTube Shorts. You can call yours anything you'd like to. And then effectively down here for the resolution, we're going to swap 1920 and 1080 around. So we're effectively swapping the horizontal aspect ratio for a vertical aspect ratio. So that's 1080 and that's 1920. Same for the aspect ratio here, 9 by 16. Frames per second, you can leave that at 25 or you can change that. I usually have mine at 30, so I'm going to put mine at 30 there. Now this video format will qualify for a YouTube short. And just so everyone's aware, you can have a square aspect ratio and square resolution. So if these numbers here and these numbers here are the same, so you could have 1080 by 1080 and then your aspect ratio would be 1 by 1, whatever you wanted it to be. As long as they all match up, then you can have a square box as well, and that will also qualify as a short. I'm going to leave mine as a full size phone resolution and then click OK. Now click Start, and now we need to drag our video clips into our playlist. There's an interesting thing that happens here. So we've just set the canvas to a certain size, and now when we drag in a video, well, it hasn't done it on this time for me, but it can reset the size of the video. If that happens, come up to settings, go to video mode, go to custom, and then click onto your YouTube Shorts. Effectively, what it can do here is forget that you've just created a new one and go back to your old version. So whatever you're on before, say you're on 1080, it will look like that when you load it up. We obviously don't want that on this occasion. So go to your settings, video mode, custom, and then YouTube Shorts for me. If you've used a different name, it will be called whatever you named it. That will set it back to the size that you actually want it to be. Now, if we drag it into the timeline, that will save as we expect. We can drag multiple videos in and onto the timeline. We can have multiple tracks and etc. And now you can use Shotcut in exactly the same way as you would usually. For this kind of video, I would suggest we either want to have some writing up here or actually zoom into the video so it looks much larger. To do that, select the timeline clip, go into your filters, add on your video filter, search for size, position and rotate, and then in your zoom section here you can zoom in to however big you want it to be. Now obviously you're not going to see the full video, but you can move it around exactly where you want it to be. You can also continue to add tracks and text as you would usually in the Shotcut video editor. Now, for it to qualify as a YouTube short, you do need to make sure that the video is under 1 minute in length, and recognize that right now YouTube are allowing anything to be under 1 minute as a YouTube short. But on the app that they've released, which I don't have access to yet, but loads of people do, and they've explained this in other YouTube videos, they can only record for 15 seconds on the YouTube app. So it might be that you want to consider reducing your YouTube short to about 15 seconds. That seems to be the times that YouTube are promoting, and therefore they may restrict it at a later date. But right now that is all hypothetical, and you can go for up to 1 minute as a YouTube short. Anything longer will just qualify as a standard video in YouTube. Finally, we need to make sure when we come to exporting the video in Shotcut that the export settings are correct. So click onto your export button and then go over to your advanced tab. Make sure you're on format as MP4, that works well with YouTube, and your video is set to the same resolution as you had it in the original settings that we set up. If they are all set as you would expect, then you can click Export File, navigate to the location you're going to save your file to, and in the jobs, that will start to export. Once that has completed, you can go to your folder location it was saved as, and then open it up, and you can see that that's saved in a vertical video format, which is now compatible with your video shorts. So I hope that's been helpful. Please consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.